G'day, it's Lance here from EarthCruiser, and I want to talk a little bit about the process of building up your DIY truck. So, similar to what happens if the vehicle is going to get turned into whatever commercial application or whatever it is, the basic premise stays the same. The process is that once you've finished building up your wonderful overland, extraordinarily wonderful, fantastic machine that you've been thinking about for years and years and years, and now you're building it, don't worry about, I know it sounds odd, but don't worry about things like check engine lights. Don't worry about some sort of odd fault code that you might see. It is actually quite common in the vehicle building industry for the vehicle to get completely finished. It will go back to the, in this case, a Isuzu dealer, and they will run through and they'll clear all those codes for you. Because in the vehicle building process, things get unplugged, plugged back in. That's really quite normal. I mean, if this one got a particularly bigger fuel tank, something's been unplugged, the computer recognizes that when it gets plugged in, so it's going to remember it. And once it starts to drive, it'll go, well, hang on a minute, that tank was unplugged. I need to notify a technician so they know to look at the, whatever gadget. That's completely, absolutely normal. So don't freak out about that. Once you get yourself finished, you get your weight on it, drive it to your dealership, let them run over, clear any codes that have happened since fuel lines or evap systems may have been unplugged as you're bolting bits and pieces on. Really normal, happens all the time, and it's pretty typical. So it's nothing you should worry about. Excellent.